I am going to explain in detail about print, electronic media and photojournalism with audience research. First one is mass media. It can be divided into printed, spoken, visual and combination of all these three. First we will see about print media. Leaflets. A leaflet is usually a single sheet of printed matter, sometimes folded. It gives accurate or specific information on a particular topic. How to write? There's important points to be noted down. First one is we have to plan for the script. In that planning, first decide on the message what you are going to use. Based on that, you select the topics related to the urgent needs of the farmer. Then sort down the how to write for leaflets. In this aspect, we must know about plan the script. First point is decide on your message, select the topics related to the urgent need of the farmer. Jot down all appropriate points. Select the most important one from the essential points. List the remaining essential points in logical order and group the desirable points together. Then write the script. While writing the script, what are the points to be considered? I will explain. Write your script with all essential points in sequence. The desirable points supporting the essential ones should be highlighted. Make the most important points catch the reader's interest. Write in a simple short sentences. Always use familiar words that should be very clear. Address your sentences to the reader. Let him make into action. Be accurate in your information. Be brief. Use illustrations and pictures in the appropriate place. Give details with reference to local situation. Start with an appeal which will be benefit to the reader. Round up the confirming what you said at the opening of your leaflet. It will reassure your reader. Mention the source where the further information on the topic or help can be obtained. Then review the script. Go over the writing after the completion and review the script. Remove the defect and rewrite it again if it is required. What are the advantages? It is highly economical, relatively easily and quickly prepared, can be preserved and used by the readers, and supplement other information and media. Now we will see about pamphlets. This is a leaflet contains from 4 to 12 pages stitched or stapled at the center. The pamphlet varies in size from 12 to 24 pages. Next we will see about circular letters. This is an effective method to convey information of common interest to large numbers of literate people at one time. More easily and quickly we can prepare this material. There are two types, one is announcement and the next one is subject matter. It must have some essential parts, like one is the introduction, then the second part explain the importance of the topic, third appeal to action and relate the action to the objective in writing a letter. Next one is a newsletter. Newsletter deals with current items of interest and normally is pointed periodically. Now we will see about newsletters. Newsletter deals with current items of interest and normally it is printed periodically. Deals with more than one subject, are printed in a large numbers and distributed in many ways. So I will explain some of the tips we have to follow in preparing newsletters. Use a salutation if necessary, such as dear farmer, hello farmer, etc. Let the length of the letter be normally 4 to 8 pages. Have desirable sizes like 6 inches by 9 inches because it should be handy. Illustrate it with realistic photos, cartoons and sketches. It attracts the readers. Let the layout be attractive. Have an attractive getup. News items may consist of periodical hints to farmers, achievements and experiences of farmers, research findings, announcements and a few statistics. Next, we will see about folders. A folder is a single piece of paper folded once or twice. The message should be presented in a sequence. Photographs, line drawings and various colors of inks and different colors of papers may be used. 4 inch by 8 inch folder is quite attractive. Folders are highly economical like leaflets. Then bulletins. Bulletin conveys large amount of information. It is a booklet running into more than 20 pages. There are two kinds of bulletins. One is technical bulletin. It is designed primarily to present scientific material to those working in specific fields. Second is a popular bulletin to present material to people in the field of extension. Then form journals. Form journals are important tools to disseminate relevant development messages to the rural audience. Next, we will see about news stories. The main purpose of the news stories are to develop interest, to inform general public, to disseminate subject matter information, to create favorable attitude among the readers. Then to reinforce other extension methods like meetings and demonstrations. Then wall newspaper. It is just like a newspaper with some illustration and printed on one side. It can be fixed on any wall or any places. Then newspapers. It carries different kinds of information like the news, some articles, tidbits like that, and the day-to-day events are presented in newspaper. Banners, this is being used in combination with or when we are organizing some campaigns. Calendars, it highlights what are the operations we have to carry out or some sequence of activities to be carried out is displayed in calendars. Now we will see about radio journalism. Special features of radio is it will reach more people in the shortest time. It is comparatively a cheaper one. Comparing the television and other media, it is cheaper one. The illiterate audience can use this. It builds enthusiasm, maintains interest among the listeners. Then while going for a radio program, you have to think of the different mode of presentation like news, interviews, discussion, documentaries, quiz, question answer, etc. Because these modes, depending on the audience, we can use these modes. For rural or tribal people, we can use drama mode like that. We can select some identified or based on the audience, we can use different modes. Then writing the news, it should be readable and listenable. Then only we can communicate properly. Then we will see about television journalism. First, we must know what the television can do or cannot do. There are some limitations like comparatively this is expensive, it cannot reach in remote places. Nowadays due to satellite it is being used in almost all remote villages. Components of good television programs. It should be relevant to the audience, understandable nature, believable, technically well made, because the visuals and audio should sync with each other. characteristics of effective television programs. First one is good design, good script, because script is characteristics of effective television programs. First one is good design. In the designing, we have to concentrate on visuals, modes and illustrations what we are using. Then good script. In television program, we must give much importance to the visuals rather script. Anyhow, the script should be simple, simple sentences should be used, it should be very clear. Then good production, it indicates the quality of the production. Attracting the attention of audience. To attract the audience based on the needs, based on the interest of the audience, we have to go for the formats. Then we have to analyze the audience preference. Based on the audience preference, we have to produce the program. Next is the budget. Because if you want to produce a program in a drama mode, it will be expensive. Based on the budget availability, we can go for, you can select different types of modes. Then time, when we are going to use. If it is before campaign, we can use this television to create awareness. Then type of information should be communicated. Just a awareness program or a skill teaching or some method demonstration, we can use this television. Length of the program should be short, because it is very difficult to control our audience, because it will come under the category of mass media. So ideal duration is 10 to 12 minutes. Suitability of format to subject matter. Based on the subject matter, we have to treat the message with suitable formats. Now let us see about formats commonly used in television program. Animation, if it is for kids and some rural youth, we can go for animation program. For skill teaching, we can go for demonstration. Documentary, drama, graphics, illustrated talk, interview, panel show, puppets, slides. Now we will see about script writing technique for form telecast programs. So in script writing, we have to concentrate on your creativity. Based on the creativity, you can very well prepare the script. Language and editing skills should be exposed. Journalist talent should be there while writing script for television. Command over the content, because time is totally restricted, so your content should be a commendable one. Capacity to put the content in a story format, in logical sequence and suitable format. Perfect visualization of entire program in the mind, then only we can produce a good program. Selection of correct format, that is method of presentation. Profile of the audience we must know, because based on that we can produce the program. Knowledge about the local terminology and illustration, this is very much essential. Sometimes in your program, if it is for a specific region, you can use local dialect. Information requirements of the farmers or viewers to be taken care of. Then photojournalism. So in our normal life, we are using photos regularly. Why? One picture is worth of 1000 words. You can very easily convey the message through photo or an illustration. A good picture draws the viewer's attention very easily. Those who read slowly can more easily grasp meanings with the help of pictures. Pictures are a universal language through which we can communicate our technologies. Make the subject matter more realistic and lively. It can replace many words. By using the photos, you can cut down the writings. Now we will see about media convergence. The past days communications, we were using direct face-to-face contact, verbal communication, then written communication. Nowadays, we are using all electronic or digital communication. We call it as a second generation communication, all with the help of the new electronic technologies available. To cite an example, high speed circuit switch data and general packet radio services, wireless application protocol WAP, 3G which enables a multimedia presentation, then third generation systems are being used. If you go for the genesis of this latest new electronic media, the IP telephony that permits the transmission of voices, video and data over computer network that were originally developed for data transmission. Nowadays, the internet communication, entertainment and computing are being used, which can communicate any type of data. The new paradigm. Nowadays, we are using internet communication, which can educate and entertain the people. WAN, voice over frame relay, local area network LAN is being used. We will see the different convergences. Payload convergence is that aspect of converged networking wherein different data types are carried in the same communication format. Protocol convergence is the movement away from multi-protocol to single protocol networks. Physical convergence occurs when payloads travel over the same physical network equipments regardless of their service requirements. Device convergence means the trend in network device architecture to support different networking paradigms in single system. Application convergence represents the appearance of the applications that integrate formally separate functions. Technology convergence signifies the move towards common networking technologies that satisfies both the LAN and WAN requirements. Institutional convergence, the institutional structures and development of the institution, what is essential to go for all sort of this convergence. Convergence regulation we will see now. DTO, direct to operator. The DTO is a step moving towards subscription channels. In DTO, channels are digitized and encrypted by the broadcaster. It operates using C-band. The signals are downloaded by the cable operator by using the integrated receiver code IRD and distributed to cable homes. The DTO transmission helps in saving of the cost, tracking the subscription revenue, but calls for additional investment for the decoders for downlinking the signals. Next is a DT gauge, direct to home, an alternative to DTO service addressing superior reception with advanced level of multi-channel subscription revenue for broadcaster. This will be more useful. DTH can broadcast more than 100 channels using IRD. Now we will see about audience research. What is audience research? Audience research is a systematic and accurate way of finding out about your audience on two main things, that is estimate audience sizes, discover audience preferences. Methods of audience research, how we can conduct. One is the survey. Second, the audience research, social research and market research share a common body of methods with slight variations. When we go for the audience research and management system, the importance of the thing to be taken care of is the feedback loop. So in this picture, the first point is get information on results of action. Then what we are doing, we correct the action. Then decide on the next action needed. From that, we are taking another action. It is a cyclic process. It can be converted. Even we can take from take action to the end point. Now the logical framework. The logical framework method begins by creating a hierarchy of goals. State the main goal that you want the project to accomplish. For example, to eliminate malaria in a region. Then consider what other goals will need to be achieved to meet the first goal. In the case of anti-malaria project, the three major objectives could be to encourage people to avoid being bitten by mosquitoes, to make anti-malarial drugs readily available, to eliminate malaria carrying mosquitoes. Now you consider what must be achieved to meet each of these goals and so on. One, making anti-mosquito equipment widely available, encouraging people to wear enough clothing at times when mosquitoes are feeding, advising people on how to avoid being bitten by mosquitoes. Audiences' projects are usually done with this order. First one is define the purpose of the research. Two, try to find out if the information you need is already available. Third one, how much is it worth to you to know this? Fourth one, which research method is most appropriate? Who will do the research? Now do the research. When the research is finished, then go for the audience feedback. Hope you got all the points what I have explained. If you have any doubt, you can visit manage website and get information. Otherwise, you can go through the notes or books available or provided with the manage for further reading. Thank you.